J.P. Morgan, what do you think about JPM?
I think Jamie Dimon should run for president along with Mayor Mike Bloomberg, and I'd like to have 20 Democrats and 10 Republicans running and spending a lot of money.
Who would you support?
I would support them all.
Man, get out of these answers. I mean, there's no disclosure about that. You can disclose it right now. 13F.
Come on, move along.
Xylem.
Xylem.
Another question.
Is,
Dave in Pennsylvania, Xylem.
Is where?
Dave in Pennsylvania.
That's who's asking the question.
Oh, I'm sorry, because they're located in White Plains, New York. And Pat Decker runs the company, and it's a spinoff from AT&T. He's done a good job of putting together a water package. And we as a country need infrastructure. You know, every time you read about lead in New Jersey homes and elsewhere, and we know we need to build the water systems and moving water around the world. This one is an attractive company. They have a little extra in Europe than I like, and they went into the metering business. So we own it. We've owned it since we've owned AT&T.
Okay.
And we think the CEO has done a good job.
I know we were just talking about J.P. Morgan, but in the context, the broader context of the financials, which are one of the best performing groups year to date, right, in this first month of the year. What do you think about that group?
I own J.P. Morgan, and I own the trust banks, and I've been a little disappointed with State Street. They just changed the CEO, but Jay Hooey did a great job. We'll probably put him in our Hall of Fame. So I continue to like the notion of making money on the net interest margin spread, making more loans. But shadow banking, which is one of the issues in this country that I'm a little concerned about because I don't fully understand it, and I don't have good numbers on it, is nipping away at these loans. And they've got to get more into the digital world. And from my end, owning a T. Rowe Price is extraordinarily attractive. Owning companies with a lot of cash on their balance sheets, serving the capital markets in the, right now are probably $73 trillion in the world and $100 trillion of debt. T. Rowe has done a great job there. Fidelity, I would buy, but Abigail's not going public, as far as I know.
But if you choose, I mean, you only own J.P. Morgan between Morgan Stanley, Goldman, Bank.
We started a new mutual fund that's run by a guy by the name of Ian Lapey. He's done a great job of covering the entire world. So we've got a lot of companies in that area. And to the degree that you want to buy a trust bank, who are the mergers going to take place? So if you go to Florida, you go to Georgia, you go to South Carolina, you go to Texas, where are people going? Where are the salt-free states? And how do you buy banks? And can you buy them at 1.5 times tangible book and go to 2.6 times? Yeah, we're there.
Okay,
a lot of banks.
You mentioned some of the auto parts makers that you own. I have another question coming in on Twitter. What about Ford? What do you think about Ford and GM?
I don't think about them.
Why not?
I've been for 50 years following the auto industry. I always did the parts. I always liked parts better than the car companies.
You ever think about Tesla?
Yes.
You own it?
I don't own a Tesla car. I'd buy a model for $2.
But forget the car. Do you own the stock?
No. I bought 100 shares of Carvana to show you how good I am. There's 40 million used cars sold a year. Carvana has 35,000 of those, growing like a weed. Carvana is the technology on used car markets, but I also own AutoNation.
Mike Jackson's AutoNation?
Yes.
By the way, Tesla got downgraded today to a sell.
Saw that.
Underperform over at RBC. What do we think of that?
More news is coming out about the layoffs. They've cut a shift, the overnight shift on production. So can demand be petering out? That's the question. That's why it was downgraded, I believe.
What about small caps? Another question on Twitter. What do you think of small caps this year?
I don't know. I don't have a company called small cap. On the other side of the coin, I think the notion of American companies that are benefiting from less regulation, that are growing the markets, that are coming to work, where CEOs come to work every day to make money for their communities and their clients and their customers, you have to buy them. I'll give you lots of companies because I have probably 120 of them that you can buy at any point in time. So I think that this is a great time to be buying, focused on companies, stock specific.
Okay, what about healthcare companies?
I don't know anything about
it. Couple of downgrades.
Look,
Pfizer
come on,
and Merck.
Stop. Celgene, Bristol Myers was supposed to be taken over by Pfizer. Okay, so they make a bid for Celgene. They've got all of this great growth, the great numbers until something happens. You're going to see a huge round of consolidation.